Welcome to the GCN Tech Show.
This week we've got a new bike from Bataclan, we've got a Bluetooth smart pump, we've got your bikes, your upgrades, and of course the bike vault.
And we've also got a certain aluminium that you couldn't weld, but now you can.
Yeah, that's going to open up the doors, I think, for lots of manufacturing techniques to be made a lot easier now. Right, first up then, Bataclan have released a new bike, the Officina Bataclan Portofino. I don't know if I pronounced that correctly or not.
Yeah, it's a bike that they've gone for the oversized steel tubes with the oversized custom steel lugs that actually Bataclan were the first to develop. They've gone for that Columbus Spirit steel look, which actually those lugs help with the ride feel as well, which I think, yeah, it looks pretty cool.
Yeah, and while we're there actually about the looks, what do you think about the colours of them?
Well, it's gone for that mocha brown, hasn't it? Which I think looks pretty classy. I don't know what you think.
Yeah, I mean, when I saw the description of it saying mocha brown and amber, I thought, if I was offered that bike, I'd probably say thank you very much, but, well, not too keen on the colour, but now I've seen it in the flesh, it looks fantastic, doesn't it?
Yeah, it looks very classy, I have to say.
Yeah, I'd say yes to one of those. And then, interestingly, if you are in the market of buying one, you're actually invited along to meet Giovanni Bataclan and discuss the requirements that you want from that bike. So, a little bit about the intended usage, as well as, obviously, to fit your exact body shape and type.
So, is this a Rolls Royce of cycling, John?
I guess so, yeah. You're going to be treated like a VIP.
Yes, you certainly will.
I might sign up for it. The old white glove treatment.
Yeah.
Materials that you would like to see bikes either being built from or possibly built from.
Yeah, so we sent Opie out on the case to do some research and he came out with this. I mean, look at those exquisite lines.
No, no, no. Honestly, we gave Chris one task, didn't we, this week? And he came back with that. What we're thinking more likely is along the lines of, well, materials that can't be joined or connected to one another because it's simply not possible.
Yes, and that did get us thinking. And, well, we found this, the latest discovery that lets the AA7075 aluminium, which wasn't able to be welded, well, it's now able to be welded.
Yeah, and this is super interesting because that stuff is a third lighter than steel. And, well, it's been around since the 1940s and used in the aeronautical industry and things like that. I got to speak to the professor, so let's have a listen to what he's got to say about his latest discovery.
You know, recently, well, for probably the last 10 years, say, all of the focus seems to be on carbon fibre manufacturing. But there's still a load of people out there who absolutely love aluminium.
Yes, I can see that because aluminium, the metal got tough. Now, especially, I would say carbon fiber is great, but they do have weakness. The shear, we talk about shear stress, when you touch your heavy frame, like you touch it on the side, they could fracture. And once you fracture, you cannot repair anymore. And metal are different. Metal have toughness, and metal also, like, they have flexibility, and then can repair. We can repair them when we have some damage. So that's the metal one. You know, I'm not saying metal will completely eliminate carbon, you will not. But the metal will fill the gap between the carbon fiber and the low end, the aluminum. And also, I personally think 7075 or 7050 aluminum alloy will offer direct competition to the carbon fibers, because we could have the similar weight and the even better, performance in a lot of cases. Yeah. This is 21st century. I see a big wave coming.
Whoa, now we're talking titanium carbide nanoparticles. And it's very exciting, actually, to see these new techniques being used finally with materials that have been around for donkey's years and available to us cyclists. And, well, we're going to get lighter aluminium bikes out of it, it seems like.
Yeah, and it opens up the door for a whole new world of bikes and components being built out of this alloy, which was previously, well, a dream.
Yeah. Are we on the edge, then, of a new era of bike frame development?
I know.
What are you thinking? What would you like to see a bike built from?
Well, I'd like to see more 3D printed bikes made out of just really incredible, materials, I guess.
Exotic stuff. I want to go actually visit a 3D printing company soon to investigate exactly how they do it and why. I mean, what about magnesium bikes? They were made back in the 80s, Kirk Precision. Didn't last very long, literally, the company or the bikes as well. Kelp as well, I think that's something to do with seaweed, isn't it?
Yeah, that's definitely seaweed.
Yeah.
Eco bricks? You can make a bike out of like an eco brick with all your excess rubbish.
I don't know. Anyway, let us know though, what would you like to see bikes being built from in the future? Because we're going to have some absolute experts out there. In seriousness, I've heard about this aluminium called tetrahedral aluminium. Super cool. It has hollow tubes running through it in the sheets, so it makes it a really strong structure and importantly, very lightweight too. But I've been pestering these big companies like Boeing and Airbus to go and visit. And well, they won't let me in through the doors. In fact, they deny using it, but I have been told by a very reliable source.
They know you too well.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, these grubby little hands.
Yeah.
I have been told by a very, very reliable source that they do use it. But if you're involved with tetrahedral aluminium, let me know because I want to come and visit. Mm, I'll bring it in as well.
Of course.
Come along for the ride.
Yeah, 100%.
Right, we received a tip-off about a new pump from Silka this week, the Viaggio, which is a smart pump because it's got a Bluetooth gauge on it, detachable handles, folding feet, and it even comes in a wax-coated canvas bag, so it's the ideal stowaway on your training camp holidays, I guess.
Oh, it sounds good. And on that, Bluetooth pressure gauge is accurate to 0.5 PSI, making it an incredibly precise tool for taking around with you, making sure your pressure is, well, absolutely perfect.
Yeah. It does look good, doesn't it?
I think it looks really good. It's sleek, and as pumps go, I think that's pretty beautiful.
Yeah, it's weird, really. I get a bit obsessive about pumps. I've got a Silka track pump at home. Probably had it for over 30 years, I reckon.
I've used it.
Yeah, the leather washer and so, yeah. I think he ruined it. Yeah. But also, I think Silka are one of the oldest pump manufacturers, if not the oldest in the world. So it's, well, I mean, they're coming up with modern things like this as well. On a final note then, regarding tech, we had this sent in from one of our viewers. And well, it's a pretty cool carbon cup, isn't it? Maybe taking inspiration from our mate Halsey, who I went up to see recently, and his carbon antics that he gets up to.
Yeah, fascinating video that. And I love seeing all that stuff that has been random, everyday things have been made out of materials that have been once used in cycling. And what have you guys been up to over the years? Have you made, you know, some loo roll holders or coat hangers or necklaces or even earrings?
Yeah. I remember once seeing actually a lady who had a couple of chain links.
Don't. John, I'm going
to
stop there.
And I went out to get my ears pierced
No, just don't get any ideas, mate.
All right, no problem. But I mean, we don't want to see your hacks and bodges, do we?
No.
We don't have room for that on here.
No.
Instead, we want to see these really cool things which you've made because, well, I think our friend there with the carbon cup holder has not even touched the surface.
No, and do get in touch because we would be really excited to see what you guys come up with.
Yeah, use that uploader tool, get involved. More tech next week. It's now time for Screw Riding Upgrades.
By Upgrades.
The part of the show where you submit before and after photos of anything cycling related, basically, where you've spent some money on it. Whether or not it's an upgraded pair of wheels, frame, you name it, you submit it. And submit it using the uploader tool down below. But before we go into this week's nominations, we need to announce last week's winner. And it was, who was it?
It last week was won by Thomas.
Oh, Thomas, get in touch with us on Facebook to arrange delivery of the Capron, as Ollie calls it. We've actually sold out in the shop, haven't we?
Yeah, we have, yeah. All sold out. Couldn't find any of them around. Yeah.
But don't worry, you won't be forgotten. As soon as they come back in stock, we will send one off to you. According to Mr. OP, Mr. Bridgewood has got 27 of them at home. Don't know what he's doing with that, other than making porridge. Right.
Does he think he's a superhero or something?
He must do with all those capes. Cape Crusader. Anyway, James, start us off then. Who have we got this week?
This week we've got Andrew from Tasmania.
Ooh, a lovely place. I've never been actually.
Nor have I.
Yeah.
About 2 years ago, Andrew purchased their first real road bike, the Avanti Giro AR1 all road gravel bike. Fast forward 12 months to one fateful day with Andrew was testing the limits of the AR1s. Off-road capability, riding downhill in a neighbor's paddock. Long story short, Andrew hit a wrought iron fence, head-on at speed. Flipping a full forward somersault into a patch of blackberries.
Blackberries?
Yeah. A damaged ego was the main injury, but unfortunately most of the bikes was ruined and busted wheels. Torn saddle, shifters, bent steering tube meant the Avanti was unrideable.
Unrideable.
Andrew started to save money in his piggy bank and got new components, including some fancy fulcrum wheels, and then repainted the frame and gave it some color to match the wheels. It turned out exactly like Andrew had hoped, rides like a dream, and he's more in love with the bike than ever.
There it is before. Look, before he went into that wrought iron fence and the blackberries. There it is.
Oh, look at that.
Andrew, beauty. You naughty boy. Look at those green cables as well.
I think that looks good, doesn't it? I love that kind of gunmetal grey with that popping fluoro green.
Yeah.
Andrew, that's a very nice bike.
Fair play to you there, Sunshine. Nice one. And I hope you've recovered. But Andrew, well, he's not going to have it all his own way this week.
No, it's not that easy.
Because he's up against Tanner from Dallas in Texas. Lovely place.
Mm.
This Specialized, it was Tanner's first road bike that he bought in college for
$800.
It came equipped with Shimano 105, which was upgraded over time with hand-me-down parts from his brother. It's pictured, though, with some old Tegra scraps on it. In 2018, Tanner decided to do a complete rebuild of this bike that wasn't worth much more than $100
to anyone.
Many, many months later, and more dollars than Tanner cares to admit, he has this updated dream bike. Custom mother-of-pearl paint job, Hunt carbon wheels, Envy fork, a SRAM 1x group set, Zip carbon stem and bars, Vittoria Corsa G Plus tan sidewalls, Arundel carbon bottle cages. Apparently the bike rides like a superbike and he's going to keep it
forever.
Right then, Tanner's, that's his bike before, look.
Look at that, nice looking bike.
Nice looking bike.
But that, my boy,
woo!
It's like pearly.
Yeah, custom mother of pearl paintwork.
Oh, that is eye-wateringly beautiful.
Yeah.
Look at it.
The background isn't quite as nice, is it? I mean, that's been shot in the corner of a room. But
no,
still,
it's like that could have been better.
Yeah.
But then look, he's even kind of connected the Hunt and the logos on the tires.
Yeah.
You know, he's
nice,
had some thought about it, isn't he?
Nice,
he's put it in the big ring and halfway down the block.
Yeah.
No, I like that, mate.
Yeah, anyway, Andrew from Australia or Tanner from Texas?
I know who I'm going for.
I think I know who I'm going to go for as well. But it's not about us, is it? Where are they going to vote, James?
Top left-hand corner.
Top right-hand corner. Left for us, though, isn't it?
Yeah, left for us.
So if we press now, we can vote.
Hang on.
There we are. Next week, we will announce, and of course, you'll be getting a cape from whoever wins. It's now time for the Bike Vault, where we rate your bike either nice
or super nice.
Yeah, and what happens then, James, if someone gets a super nice?
Well, I get to ring the bell, John.
The town crier, as I call him in the office, because he's got a beaming voice that's always laughing at something. I don't know what.
Oh, hey, oh, hey, oh, hey.
There something like that, yeah. So if you want to submit your bike into the Bike Vault for the chance of, well, getting stamped super nice, how do they do it?
Well, they go to the uploader tool and the description is in the way, or all the details are in the description below.
Yeah, simple as can be.
Yeah.
Right, let's crack on. The first one in this week is Kashif from their terrace. Now, Kashif, last week I did say, please do give a detailed description of where you're from. The terrace, not quite what I was getting at there, buddy, but nice effort. Anyway, this is Kashif's Fuji Sportif 2.3. It's got a Claris group set on there, 5239 chainrings, 1132 cassette.
Nice.
Yeah, nice looking bike there, isn't it?
Very simplistic. So you got all black, I like that.
Yeah.
Black kind of guy, and then you got the white decals of Fuji. Yeah, I think that looks pretty cool.
Yeah, it's a nice looking bike.
I personally am not going to give it a super nice.
I think you could have done more with the background than that.
Yeah, really. I think the background means a lot because it makes the bike pop.
Yeah, and at the moment it's just not popping enough for us, is it?
It's just not really. Yeah, and yeah, I think I'm like you, John. It's just not. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice bike, Kashif. Right, who's up next then?
Well, we've got Matthew Lux from San Diego in that lovely part of California.
Ooh, yes.
The Serotto or Trot.
Ooh, big bike, isn't it?
It's very big. I definitely wouldn't get my leg over that,
for
sure.
That is I'd hope so too.
Nice carbon custom stem up there.
Yeah, looks like an AX Lightness or something. Or a THM, possibly.
He's got ceramic oversized jockey wheels.
Yeah.
He's got a red chain to match the ceramic speed jockey wheel.
Yeah, that's KMC, isn't it? THM.
And he's also linked up the valves with that red throughout. So he's got a red decal, you know, going on, which is quite cool. Yeah. I quite like that. And he's also got that on his bottles.
Quick release skewer on the wrong side, though, on the front wheel, it looks like, doesn't it? The lever. Is it? It is.
But he's got nice cranks as well.
Yeah,
like naked carbon,
fancy, aren't they?
Yeah.
Clavicules. I can't quite. I haven't got contact in all my glasses.
He's got amazing, like, nice group set.
Yeah. But I don't know. I like it, but I don't know if it's super nice for me.
Yeah, I mean, it's got some amazing kit on it.
Yeah, there's amazing kit on it, but I feel like if it was taken not quite so uphill, maybe just something more to it. I don't know. I'm torn. Personally, I think it's a nice bike.
I'll go with you on that, John. Yeah, nice bike.
Yeah.
But thank you for sending it in, because that's actually
great looking bike.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, next up is Louison from Cambrai in France. Willia Triestina Iswad XP. Full Ortega group set, zip, 454 wheels, Ritchie carbon seat post, it looks like. Looks like lizard skin bar tape as well on there, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's another black and red-esque look about it. I'm not sure what's going on with that saddle. It's very pointy down. I think I'd slide off that. Yeah. I'd also personally cut that steerer. Not that I'm one to judge because I haven't cut mine yet, but think about that.
Yeah, the wheels I think could do with better alignment, possibly, as well.
I like the 454s.
Yeah, but I mean, just, you know.
But yeah, I know what you're saying.
Like, but the valve is at the bottom.
Yes. Yeah. The intricate details. Yeah. The intricate details.
Quite a bit of moss as well in the grouting there of the stones as well. Louison, come on. Little jet washer, eh?
Yeah, I'm personally not sold on that one. I'm sorry. I'm going to have to give that just a nice from me.
I'm giving a nice there from me too. Right, who is next then?
I've got Patrick from the Marina Bay in Singapore.
Oh, lovely part of the world.
That's very true. With the 2013 Argon 18 Krypton with Shimano 105 and R7000 group set. Woo! I'm just going to go straight in and say I'm not loving the background.
No.
Assigned to the...
To the toilets.
It isn't really... Yeah.
Also, that little... Underneath the chain set there, that sort of drain.
Is it a bin?
Well, I don't know, but that's the creepy emoji thing when you see like a clown coming out of a hole, isn't it, from the drain?
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, it's a bit blurry, the photo with the back wheel, look.
Yeah, but it's a nice bike. It's just not a super nice, so I'm going to give that a nice.
It's a nice bike for me too. Yeah. Nice one, Patrick. Right.
Please, I want this to be a super nice.
Well, who knows? Right, next one is Victor from Los Angeles in California. Second one in from California this week.
An LA bike.
Yeah, 2018 Pinarello Dogma F10 disc. Don't see many of those around, actually, do you?
You don't, but that, I have to say, is eye-popping. You've got the orange, that really solid orange, with the gold Pinarello decals.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's obviously out on a ride because he's got his saddlebag on there and two full water bottles.
Yeah. Hydration is key. Isn't it?
He's got a good group set. He's got the zip wheels.
Yeah. Rear light.
What tires he got on there?
Pirelli tires. Unusual choice there, Pirelli's. But a wise choice, a fine choice. I think it looks...
I love that background.
Yeah,
that's... We like the background because it just really shows off the bike. And that is really arty and actually pretty cool. I'm a very big fan of that, actually.
Yeah. It's been taken at 13 Pershing Avenue, by the looks of things, if you see that.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it's used, that house.
No, it doesn't. No, no.
Oh, I'm going to go out. John, I'm going to give that... Can I ring the bell?
You may.
A super nice.
Look at that.
Thank you for sending that one in, because I was desperate. To ring that bell.
Only one this week as well.
I know.
I think that's probably the first time ever.
Really?
I don't know. We're on episode, I think this is episode number 60. First time I can ever remember just one super nice.
Well, keep sending your bikes in because we really, really do love getting them and looking through all your bikes.
Yeah, use that uploader tool to your heart's content. And please, a more detailed description than the terrace.
Yeah.
Next week, more bike. So there we are, nearly the time for the end of the show, but don't worry because, well, we've got loads more great content coming up this week, haven't
we? Yeah, I have to say, we've got some really exciting stuff, and thanks again for having me, and don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it.
Yeah, and share it with your mates too, and also, why not check out the shop at
shop.globalcyclingnetwork.com,
where we've got a whole heap of goodies for you to check out, and also make sure you press that notification button so each and every time we put a video live, you get an alert that goes something like... Oh, that's perfection, isn't it? And now for an absolutely great video, how about clicking on him?
Yeah, and another fantastic video. Why don't you check out the video here on him?
See you soon.